In this video, I'll explain the differences between crypto coins versus tokens. Imagine that you've decided to start working out. Planning out your routine, you've come to a crossroads. Should you purchase your own equipment or sign up for a gym membership? Both positions have their own pros and cons. If you were to buy your own training equipment, this would allow you to be independent and train whenever you like. On the other hand, it would cost a lot of money and would require you to build a mini gym for yourself, all on your own. These are the issues that would be avoided by buying a gym membership. So, this example illustrates the relationship between crypto coins and tokens perfectly, with their cons and pros equally. Before we dive deep into the explanation, I'd like to welcome you to Crypto Finally Explained, the top YouTube channel for cryptocurrency education. Here, we explain cryptocurrency topics using visual stories, simple analogies, and different examples, so no matter if you're 5 or 75, you'll be able to understand them. In this video, we're comparing crypto coins versus tokens. To be more specific, we'll talk about what these two assets are, what are their main differences, and why this is something that you should know about in the first place. Ready? Let's get right to it. What are crypto coins and tokens? To start things off, before we can really get into the comparison between crypto coins and tokens, we do need to figure out what these two assets are in the first place. Some of the most popular examples of crypto coins include Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Binance coin. In other words, they are popular and very large crypto assets that have some sort of a broad function associated with them. Tokens, on the other hand, are smaller crypto assets that usually serve a much more niche and specific purpose than coins. On top of that, tokens can't exist on their own. Instead, they're hosted on the blockchain of a crypto coin. So, you can see tokens are so-called child coins, based on parent coins, the big ones' environments. Here, it's also worth mentioning that the term cryptocurrency can refer to both coins and tokens. It's situation dependent. So, to make it clear, here's an example for you. Imagine if coins are visualized as operating systems on your computer. Maybe Microsoft Windows or Apple's macOS. Then crypto tokens are the programs that you launch in those Windows or macOS environments. Still, Microsoft Windows, as a parent software, can run without any additional programs. But with extra child apps, let's say Chrome Internet Browser, Microsoft Office Package, and Cyberpunk Game, it is more versatile and fun. Simple enough, isn't it? Now, a blockchain is a place where data or information is stored. I won't go into detail on the topic in this video, but if you're really interested to learn more about it, you can check out my explanatory video about what blockchains are on our Crypto Finally Explained channel. Also, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons to make me motivated to spend my time on animating and sharing complex crypto topics in an easily understandable way. That being said, let's reiterate the earlier point. Crypto coins have their own blockchains, while crypto tokens are hosted on already existing blockchains of the coins. In other words, tokens do not have their blockchain of their own, but they are children of bigger parents, coins, and they use their parents' blockchain to launch and operate themselves. Another way you can look at it is via the example I've given at the start of the video. If you're looking to start working out and want to build a miniature gym of your own, with your own equipment, that is, you will be investing money, time, and a lot of patience. This is the same as when developing a new cryptocurrency. The developers must code the entire logic and functionality model of a brand new blockchain behind the future coin. Sticking with this example, taking out a local gym membership will save you both money and a lot of time as well. Thus, creating a token on an existing blockchain environment is much easier. No matter what sort of a function it will serve, the core underlying logic behind it will still be that of the blockchain that it's built on. When discussing crypto coins and tokens, your best bet would be to think about Ethereum. It's the second largest crypto project in the world, right after Bitcoin, and is often referred to as the global computer. The vast majority of all tokens on the current market are developed, created, and launched on the Ethereum blockchain. Without getting too technical, the main reason why this is the case is because Ethereum provides probably the best and easiest environment for token launching, and it was the first highly adopted coin with such a smarter blockchain environment that supports this functionality. By the way, I already explained this topic deeply in my What Are Smart Contracts video, so go and watch it if you want to get a broader picture. Jumping back, a great example of the more well-known Ethereum-based tokens would be the so-called stablecoins. And yes, it sounds weird, but this is one of the only situations where tokens are called quote-unquote coins, even if they are still created on a parent blockchain of Ethereum and not on their own. But they're special tokens, and here's why. A stablecoin is a type of crypto token whose price is pegged or tied to the value of the dollar, and which are, hopefully, backed by actual dollars as well. In other words, one stablecoin will always be worth $1. It's like a virtual US dollar on the blockchain, with the same value of a tangible US dollar in the real world. To get a broader picture, the most popular stablecoin today is USDT, or Tether. Tether is huge! As of making this video, it's the third largest crypto asset, right after Bitcoin and Ethereum, and possesses a market capitalization of over $78 billion. And as I've mentioned before, one Tether will always be worth one US dollar in value. This will never change. If Tether is so incredibly huge, then why doesn't it have a blockchain of its own? Once again, this is because of just how good Ethereum is when it comes to launching such crypto assets as stablecoins or any other types of tokens. The team behind Ethereum is constantly improving the technology and making it easier, universal, and faster for developers to create and deploy tokens on the ETH blockchain. Developers of new tokens don't really need to think about building their own blockchain environment from scratch. They get fully universal functionality of Ethereum, all pre-ready in the box. Want to find out more about Ethereum or Tether? Leave a comment below about what crypto topic you want me to animate and discuss next. Also, subscribe to not miss out on my explanations of these topics in the upcoming weeks. Continuing on with the video, we've established what crypto coins and tokens are. Now, what are the actual main differences between these two? Well, the biggest difference is just that. While crypto coins have blockchains of their own, tokens use the blockchains of existing coins. It's worth mentioning that not all blockchains allow for tokens to be created on them, however. Think about it this way. Imagine that each crypto coin is some sort of a building. There are bigger buildings, smaller buildings, and so on. Furthermore, all of them serve different functions and have different features, right? For example, some buildings have large garages where you can store a lot of cars. Then there are small buildings, for example, private houses, that might not have a designated place for a car in general. Well, in this case, let's imagine that crypto tokens would actually be the cars that can be stored, or not, in the buildings in the virtual city that we just mentioned. In the same manner, some crypto coin blockchains allow developers to create tokens on them, while others do not. Why? Because coin developers simply designated their blockchains that way, just to serve different purposes. Some coins were built with the intention to just serve their own mission. For example, Bitcoin. It was designed to just be the money equivalent in the virtual world, and that's it. On the opposite side, other coins were designated to serve not just their own, but also additional features, by sharing their own functionality with tokens that could be launched and functioning in accordance with the mother coin on which those blockchain tokens were launched. The most popular blockchains for token creation are Ethereum, the Binance Smart Chain, and Tron. Another big difference between coins and tokens is that coins usually serve a larger purpose and are more general in their use, while token utility concentrates on a specific project. Sounds confusing? Allow me to give you a few examples. Let's take Bitcoin, or the Uniswap token. Bitcoin is the largest cryptocurrency on the market. Most people agree that its use case is that of a store of value. Meaning, people invest in Bitcoin with the hope that their investments will grow in value, or at least that their money will retain its value. A very general and broad use case, wouldn't you agree? Now, the Uniswap token is a token of the most popular decentralized crypto exchange, Uniswap. The exchange allows you to trade one type of Ethereum token for another, in an anonymous manner, and without any official company overseeing the process. Thus, it's decentralized. The Uniswap token, however, isn't required for those trades. So, what is it even used for then? Well, Uniswap token holders will be able to vote for changes and upgrades made on the exchange in question, and might receive some discounts when swapping other tokens on the platform. Here, the use case of the Uniswap token is very niche and related strictly to the decentralized exchange platform. Another great example would be the earlier mentioned Ethereum coin and its well-known token called Shiba Inu. Ethereum blockchain allows developers to create crypto projects in a fast and efficient manner by using special Ethereum features such as smart contracts. Smart contracts are basically automated agreements between two or more parties. I won't go too in-depth into the topic in this video, but if you're interested to learn more about it, you can check out our dedicated video on what are smart contracts and how do they work. For now, it should suffice to say that smart contracts are an essential part of the Ethereum network. Essentially, Ethereum is used as a launchpad for other crypto projects. It's like a computer that you run programs on. The Shiba Inu token, on the other hand, would be one of these programs, a token of the Ethereum blockchain. It was created on Ethereum, and this means that Shiba Inu has all of the fundamental characteristics of the Ethereum blockchain. It works in accordance to the logic of this network. However, you might wonder then, what's the purpose of this token? Well, Shiba Inu was created as something that's known as a meme token. Essentially, it has no single clear purpose and is mostly used for investment and meme purposes. Nowadays, you may also use Shiba Inu to donate to certain animal charities, and there's artwork being created that's inspired by the project. But once again, its uses are very niche. Moving on, we've now covered what are crypto coins and tokens, and how they're different from one another. The last thing that we need to discuss in this video is the question of why these things should even matter to you in the first place. As you might have gathered already, coins and tokens are very different in how they work. Thus, anyone who is interested in crypto should be able to differentiate between the two and explain the differences. It's one of the biggest questions in crypto. It makes sense. However, to tell you my honest opinion, apart from being savvy about the crypto topic and understanding how crypto works, you aren't really going to need to know the specific differences between coins and tokens, especially if you're simply investing in or trading crypto. Sure, depending if it's a coin or a token, the transaction or trading fees are going to be different, and the logic behind the project will possess different features and quirks too. But to your average investor, this usually does not matter. Instead, people look into the actual projects and their value proposition, not whether it's a coin or a token. What do you think? Does it really matter whether your favorite project is a token or a coin? If so, why? I'd genuinely love to hear your opinion in the comments down below. With that said, I want to thank you so much for watching this video. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. I really hope that you've learned something new, and most of all, I hope to see you in our next video.